Kyle highlighted fission of bone. There are two types of fission of bone. One is homolytic and another is heterolytic. Homolytic type of fission means when AB goes under homolytic fission, then it gives A free radical and B free radicals. Whereas if AB goes under heterolytic fission, then it gives A positive plus B negative, or AB goes in A negative plus B negative. So these two are the type of fission. It is symmetrical bond breaking in which constituent atom acquire their electrons. If A, B are linked through a covalent bond, then A, B acquire their electrons to produce A radical, A free radical and B free radicals. The odd electron on A and B are known as free radicals. The product of homolytic bond fission is always results in formation of free radicals. They are always symmetrical, whereas heterolytic are asymmetrical. We can take one good example as when Cl and Cl goes under homolytic fission in presence of UV ray, we get two Cl free radical. We will use this in chapter alkene as well, and this is very important step which is included in step first of halogenation in chapter alkane. In chapter alkane, step one reaction is this one. So this is homolytic fission is very important. And heterolytic fission, it is asymmetrical bond breaking in which more electronegative atoms abstract electron pair from a covalent bond to give negatively charged species known as carboanion or anion. The less electronegative, for example B here and A here, the less electronegative atom acquire positive charge due to loss of electron, it is known as anion, or in case of carbon it is called carboanion. In case of carbon it is called carbocation and it is called carboanion. Okay, positive is cation, Ca positive ion, this is positive ion, N ion, this is negative ion. So cation and anion. When AB reacts to give A plus and B minus, or AB reacts to give A minus plus B plus, then A is more electronegative, here B is more electronegative. All these A free radical, B free radical, A cation, A anion, B cation, B anion, all intermediates, they all are intermediate in any chemical reaction. Some chemical in chemical reaction they come because they are intermediate of chemical reaction, and they are very reactive. These are very important points. So this is all about fission. Physical properties of alkyl halides. The state of alkyl halides mostly of low molecular weight are in gaseous state, and medium molecular weight are in liquid state, whereas heavy are in solid state. Now important thing is about solubility. They repel water, so they are not soluble in water. Also we can say they are hydrophobic. Hydro means water, phobic means scared. Alkyl halides are insoluble, they aren't soluble in water. They repel water. Whereas they are soluble in benzene and ether. They are soluble in benzene and ether, whereas they are not soluble in water. Now another important point about boiling point of alkyl halide. This is very very important, boiling point of alkyl halide. Boiling point of alkyl halide mainly depends upon two things. One is carbon chain and another is branching. The longer the carbon chain, longer the surface area occupied by alkyl halide, and more the surface area, more the van der Waals force. So there will be more boiling point. And more branching means decrease in surface area. So decrease in van der Waals force, so decrease in boiling point. So more the number of carbon, more the van der Waals force, more the boiling point. Less the number of carbon, less the van der Waals force, less the boiling point. In case of branching, when we see in between this molecule, hydrogen CH3 and hydrogen here, and if we do branching here, CH3, that's it, is occupying more area, it is occupying less area. So surface area occupied by carbon will be decreased if branching is increased. So surface area decrease means van der Waals force decrease, boiling point decrease. It all depends upon surface area. And comparatively between alkyl halide and alkane, alkyl halide has higher boiling point than alkane. Why? This is because of polarity, CH2Cl and CH4. When we see in between these two, there are more poles developed in case of alkyl halide than alkane. So there is higher boiling point in alkyl halide than in alkane. So this is very very important. Boiling point is very very important from physical properties of alkyl halides. Now classifications of alkyl halide. There are mainly three types of alkyl halides. They are 1 degree, 2 degree and 3 degree. 1 degree means CH3, CH2, Br. Alkyl halide attached carbon means the main carbon has only one relation with carbon. This is called 1 degree. Now in 2 degree, carbon, carbon and X. This is second degree. And on 3 degree, this is 3 degree alkyl halide. Preparation of alkyl halides from alkane. This method is especially useful in industries for the preparation of mixture of alkyl halides. There are different mixtures that are prepared from alkane during the preparation of alkyl halides. In this reaction, alkanes are treated with halogen. Alkanes are taken and they are treated with halogens in presence of UV ray, in presence of sunlight. In halogens include chlorine, bromine, iodine and not fluorine, because fluorine is explosive. In presence of sunlight to form alkyl halide is major product. The mechanism of this reaction proceeds through free radical formation. The reaction goes in this way. When alkane is treated with halogens like chlorine, fluorine, bromine, bromine and iodine, not fluorine, then we get RCl plus HCl. In this way we can prepare alkyl halide from alkane. But the reaction may go further, and Cl2, if applied more excess Cl2, then we can get as if it was CH3Cl, then it will be CH2Cl. CH4 plus Cl2 gives CH3Cl gives, in presence of UV ray, in presence of UV ray, CHCl2 Cl3, in presence of UV ray, in presence of UV ray, CCl4. The reaction proceeds in this way. For example, if we have a question like this, what would be the product? The product would be, this Cl will replace one hydrogen and sit here. This is toluene, H2Cl plus HCl, right? This is called benzyl chloride. Now we are going to study the preparation of alkyl halide from alkene. We can get alkyl halide from alkene by adding some amount of acid. For example, if we have carbon double bond carbon and we have HX, then hydrogen goes and sits on one of the carbon, X goes and sits on another carbon, and then we get CX, single bond, CH, in this way. For example, in this case, the hydrogen goes and attaches here by my Markovnikov's rule, and bromine goes and attaches in this carbon. So we get the product is bromine here and then CH3 here. Plus, what would be the byproduct? HBr? No. No byproducts. One only H2 will be. Nothing will be byproduct. This is 2-bromopropane. 2-bromopropane is 2-bromopropane. We have learned from alkene. Now we are going to study about from alcohol. It is widely used method for the preparation of alkyl halides. In this reaction, alcohol is treated with anhydrous zinc chloride to obtain alkyl halide. When alcohol is treated with acid in presence of anhydrous zinc chloride, then we get alkyl halide plus water. So what did we do in laboratory preparation? We took alcohol, make it react with acid and anhydrous zinc chloride, we get alkyl halide plus water. This is very easy and widely used method. However, if rearrangement is possible, anhydrous zinc chloride permits rearrangement of halide molecule. To minimize rearrangement, we can use reagents like SOCl2, PCl5, and PCl3. We use anhydrous zinc chloride in lab, but if it can bring rearrangement, so it can move the X from 1 degree to 2 degree to 3 degree carbons. So we can use SOCl2, PCl5, and PCl3 to get our wanted result, wanted product. For example, if we take RCS2OS, this alcohol, and SOCl2, then SOCl2, the SO portion wants to make SO2, and Cl portion wants to combine with hydrogen, whereas another wants to go here. So we get result. Product is RCS2Cl plus HCl plus SO2. This reaction works under pyridine catalyst. The same reaction goes on with PCl5 as well and PCl3 as well. Now we have studied from alkene. Now from alkene, from alcohol, and from, now we are going to study from alkyl halide. Preparing alkyl halide from alkyl halide, how is it possible? It is possible when we put RCl plus I minus, then it gives Ri plus Cl minus. Because I is more electronegative than C chlorine, so I will replace chlorine and then give its result. For example, another will be, example will be NaI. It gives CH3I plus NaCl. This is very important and important example from alkyl halide, preparation of alkyl halide from alkyl halide. Main laboratory preparation, what do we do in lab? We need to understand this. Now, nucleophilic reactions. What are the nucleophilic reactions given by alkyl halide? First of all, we need to understand nucleophilic. What does this nucleophilic means? Nucleophilic means nucleus loving, that is proton loving, means positive loving. Who loves positive? Negative. Negative loves positive. Those species which contains lone pair of electron or bears negative charge are called nucleophile. Lone pairs of electrons, which means negative charge, which has lone pair of electrons or negative charge, they are called nucleophiles. Then what is electrophile? Those species which bears positive charge or they are electron deficient. What are electrophiles? They are electrons, electrons deficient or bears positive charge. What are electrophiles? Lone pairs of electrons, negative charge. Electron deficient are electrophiles, electron deficient, and which bears positive charge. This is very, very important. What are the things that gives nucleophilic reaction? So we need to take the example of nucleophiles. NH3 is a nucleophile. Cl, OH minus, Cl, Br, all halide ions, NH3, they are nucleophiles. ROOH, this is also a kind of nucleophile. Then what are electrophiles? Electrophiles are NO2 plus NH3, NH2 or NH4 plus, NH3 or whatever, AlCl3. AlCl3 is a electrophile. AlCl3 is a electrophile. AlCl3 is a electrophile. Nucleophilic reactions. Now we are going to study about nucleophilic reactions. What do we do in nucleophilic reaction? First, addition of aqueous KOH, reaction with moist Ag2O, and reaction with sodium alkoxide, reaction with ammonia. Aqueous KOH, Ag2O, sodium alkoxide, and ammonia. So what do we do in addition of aqueous KOH? Rx plus aqueous KOH gives ROH plus KX. As simple as that. What would be the example? Example would be this. Now what is another? A reaction with Ag2O. Reaction with KOH, reaction with Ag2O, reaction with sodium alkoxide, reaction with ammonia. Reaction with aqueous KOH, reaction with Ag2O, reaction with sodium alkoxide, reaction with ammonia. Reaction with moist Ag2O. Moist Ag2O reacts to give Ag2O plus H2O gives 2AgOH. Now alkyl halide reacts with AgOH to give ROH plus AgX. It's simple as that. At first, moisture reacts with silver oxide to give silver hydroxide, which reacts with alkyl halide to give alcohol and silver halide. Now reaction with sodium alkoxide, reaction with aqueous KOH, reaction with moist Ag2O, reaction with sodium alkoxide, reaction with ammonia. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिएक्शन फ्रॉम ईथर सिंथेसिस एज वेल. इट इज द बेस्ट मेथड फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ ईथर मॉलिक्यूल. द रिएक्शन ऑफ अल्काइल हैलाइड विद सोडियम अल्कोक्साइड टू फॉर्म ईथर इज नोन एज विलियमसन सिंथेसिस. विलियमसन रोना रोरा रोना आर ओ एन ए रोरा आर ओ आर. द रिएक्शन गोज इन दिस वे. व्हेन अल्काइल हैलाइड रिएक्ट्स विद रोना आर ओ एन ए प्लस दिस नेगेटिव पोर्शन दिस पॉजिटिव पोर्शन then these two combines to give NaX then ROR is formed. This is R dash. For example CH3Cl reacts with Na plus O minus CH3 then it gives NaCl as byproduct. CH2CH3 let's take another example. CH3O CH2CH3 this is called ether. It is also called ether. Now fourth reaction, that is reaction with ammonia, reaction with aqueous KOH, reaction with moist Ag2O, reaction with sodium alkoxide, Williamson Rona Rora, reaction with ammonia. यो चाहिँ अल्काइल हैलाइडले अमोनियासँग रिएक्सन गरेको भन्दा रिएक्सन गरेको भन्दा यो अमोनियामा चाहिँ अल्काइल हैलाइड आएर टाँसिएको भनेर बुझ्दा हुन्छ. किनभने यो एक्सलाई सुरुमा रिप्लेस गर्छ यसले है एनएच3को एचलाई रिप्लेस गर्छ. एनएच3को चाहिँ एच रिप्लेस भइरहेको छ यो एक्सले गर्दाखेरि. अब अझै के हुन्छ अझै ट्रिट गऱ्यौँ भने आर एन एच रहन्छ यतातिर आर जोडिन्छ. त्यसै गरी अझै रिएक्सन गरिराख्यौँ भने आरएन यतातिर आर जोडिन्छ. यस्तो फर्म हुन्छ. दिस इज कल्ड रिएक्सन विथ अमोनिया. अल्काइल हैलाइड्स रिएक्ट विथ अमोनिया टु गिभ अमाइन्स. द रिएक्सन प्रोसिड्स अन्टिल अल हाइड्रोजन आइटम्स अफ अमोनिया आर रिप्लेस्ड बाई अल्काइल ग्रुप. यति मात्रै छैन, यसको बारेमा अरू पनि विभिन्न कुराहरू मैले बुझ्नुपर्नेछ. त्यसको लागि नोट्सहरूमा पनि हेर्नुपर्ने गर्ने हुन्छ र विभिन्न रिसर्चहरू पनि गर्नुपर्ने हुन्छ. अनदर टपिक रेट अफ रिएक्सन इफेक्ट अफ कन्सन्ट्रेसन. फर अ रिएक्सन टु अकर मलिक्युल्स मस्ट कोलाइड विथ इच अदर. हाउएभर अल कोलिजन डो नट लिड टु प्रोडक्ट फर्मेसन. ओन्ली दोज कोलिजन विल फुलफिल द क्राइटेरिया. द क्राइटेरिया only those collisions will fulfill the following criteria results in the chemical reaction. What are the criteria? The criteria is the collision must be sufficiently energetic. The colliding molecule must have proper orientation. O-R-I-E-N T-A-T-I-O-N, orientation. It is assumed that the number of sufficiently elastic collision depends on the total number of colliding molecules since the rate of reaction depends on the rate of collision. So what is the rate of reaction? Rate of reaction is equals to rate of collisions, that is number of collisions per second. Thus the rate of reaction depends upon the collision frequency, energy factor and orientation factor. Only three things: energy factor, collision frequency, collision factor and orientation factor. So three vectors: collision frequency, collision factor and orientation factor. Collision factor is also called energy factor and orientation factor is also called probability factor. So what is collision frequency? Collision frequency means something that depends upon the frequency that depends upon concentration, pressure, size of an atom, mobility of an atom, weight of an atom, temperature, etc. It has been found that rate of reaction increase with increase in concentration, temperature also plays vital role in determining the rate of reaction. Collision frequency is such a thing that depends upon concentration, pressure or temperature, size of an atom, mobility or weight of an atom. एनर्जी फैक्टर और कोलिजन फैक्टर. दिस इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट फैक्टर विच डिटरमाइन द रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन. इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द टेम्परेचर एंड एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी. एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ अ केमिकल रिएक्शन. द फ्रैक्शन ऑफ कोलिजन विद एनर्जी ग्रेटर देन एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी इज गिवन बाय e to the power activation energy open RT, where R means universal gas constant and T means absolute temperature. It is the most important factor which determine the rate of reaction. It depends upon temperature and activation energy. Okay, energy factor. So what is energy factor? E to the power minus activation energy by universal gas constant times temperature. It depends upon activation energy and temperature. This is energy factor. Another one is orientation factor. Orientation factor is also known as probability factor. The colliding molecules with similar shape and size undergo similar type of reaction. However, this orientation factor isn't clearly understood yet.